Hey, welcome to another episode of AppScript Office Hours. I'm Jan Kleinert. We have a new team member here with us today. This is Arun. So he's joining us for the first time. And he's also a member of the AppScript Developer Relations team. So let's go ahead and get started. Before we jump into the questions that we have in the moderator page, I wanted to show you something in the Chrome Web Store that we added this week. So I'm going to turn on screen sharing here and show you this window. So we posted a Google App Script app, which basically will take you to script.google.com, which is the standalone script editor, in the Chrome Web Store actually just yesterday, I guess it was. So if you use Chrome and you also use AppScript a lot, this would be a handy web app for you to install. What it will do is you'll get an icon for AppScript on your new tab page. It'll make it easy for you to find it and launch it. So check it out. And it simply will take you to script.google.com to the standalone script editor. So let me jump over to Google Moderator here. So we have four or five questions, and we'll just work through them here. And then once we're done with that, I'll jump back to the Hangout, and we can take any live questions that we have. So the first one here, let me refresh to make sure that we have the most up to date. Okay. So is there a time frame for adding the rest of the UiApp widgets to the GUI builder? Thanks for addressing my question on September 6th. Sorry I missed the live Hangout by a few minutes. Said I'd look into it and provide feedback. So that's right, I did. And I don't have concrete feedback yet. One question I got in response was, which specific widgets would be most useful to you? Are there certain ones, like a small subset of ones that you are looking for specifically to be in GUI Builder? Or, you know, do you really just want everything that's available in UiApp to be there in the GUI Builder? Knowing specific ones that would be the most valuable would help us prioritize. But again, I don't have any concrete information on when, if we'll be adding all the UiApp widgets to the GUI Builder at this time. But I will continue to check on that, and I'll update if we have more.
Are you sharing the screen?
I am, yes. So, yes, hopefully everybody can see this. And the link to the moderator questions is also available from the Google developers, developers.google.com/live from the entry there. It should be embedded in the page. Second question is on triggers. So I keep running into situations where I wish I could immediately trigger a script, maybe by SMS or on receipt of an email. 1-minute triggers won't work for this use case. Is there a workaround, or does Google plan on providing a live event trigger or even a post trigger? So this is a really good question. For those of you who aren't familiar with triggers are basically a way to execute an AppScript function after some sort of event happens. So it could be a time-based trigger where you have this trigger run every 5 minutes, so that would be a clock-based event. Or in the case of Google Spreadsheets, we do have some of these event-based triggers. So when a Google Spreadsheets form is submitted, or when a spreadsheet is opened, or when a spreadsheet is edited, it can fire off an event as well. Outside of Google Spreadsheets, we don't currently have kind of like product-based event triggers. But if that is, it sounds like that is something that this poster wants. So what would be really helpful here is in the issue tracker to raise a feature request for us with the specific types of event triggers that you're looking for. What are the ones that would help you be able to do the use cases that you can't currently do today? We are looking into the possibility of adding additional event triggers, but I don't have specifics on which ones, when, that sort of thing right now. But it's always helpful for us to know what it is that you want the most. So do let us know in the issue tracker for that. Okay, the third one here, display of data in a UI. And I'm assuming it looks like this is a question related to UiApp. So it's not a problem for data with multiple records at once. So you can use a grid or flex table for that. But how to display data where you only want to see one record at a time, with buttons for next, back, first, last to click through the records. So off the top of my head, I don't think we have a built-in UiApp widget that will do this for you. I can visualize in my head what you're talking about. It's the kind of almost like a record in a database viewer kind of thing. I don't think there's a built-in one supported by UiApp. So I think if you wanted something like this, you would probably have to build it yourself. So you could have a panel in the center that would pull in the panel with labels, maybe, that would pull in the data that you want to display for each individual record. And then you could hook up buttons. So you could hook up a button for next that calls a function that loads the next record and refreshes the panel and the data, and the same thing for back and first and last. So we don't have something out of the box, I don't think, that will do this for you, but you could build something that would do that. Let's see. And I'm just going to jump over and make sure we're not getting any follow-ups in the chat window. Looks like we're not. Okay. So for a spreadsheet cell, what is the best way to test if the value is a hyperlink? So I went ahead and put a link in the response here. If I'm understanding the question correctly, you have a spreadsheet where some of the cell values may be hyperlinks, and you want to be able to determine which ones and then do something based on that. So from your script, you could pull in the values of the cells, and then what I think would probably be the simplest would be to basically run a regular expression, run a matcher against that, and determine if, you know, the value in that cell matches a URL format. It's actually kind of tricky to build a good regular expression for validating URLs, but here's an article I just ran across that had some tips for, depending on how complete and how fancy you want to get, some different ways to build URLs. URL regular expression matchers. So hopefully that's helpful. And then this last question here, is there an easy way to access the Google Drive API, not the DocList default services from AppScript? Okay, so URL fetch OAuth config doesn't work because Drive API requires OAuth too. So, and I think we may have Jan on the live hangout here. So related to that, is this the Drive SDK that you're looking for? So this is the API for actually integrating a web app with Google Drive. If you can hear me and you're there, you can type into the chat window if you... Here we go. We've got some typing going on. So more or less, yes. So if it requires OAuth 2, and I think you're correct that our current OAuth support is not supporting OAuth 2 yet, that may not be possible at this time. I will go back and check with the team to see if there's a workaround for that. But I think that if they only support OAuth 2, it may not be possible yet. So I will verify that and let you know. Update this moderator entry so that you can have like a solid answer. You know, we do know that there are lots of use cases out there where we need OAuth 2 support, so that's something that's on our roadmap that we're working towards, but we don't have the OAuth 2 support in AppScript yet. Any other questions from our live Hangout participants today? I'll turn off screen sharing for now. No questions? Okay. Well, our usual... Oh, here we go. We have a... Okay, so Jan is talking about the API from developers.google.com/drive. Let me just click over and take a quick look at that. Yes, so that is... Right, that is the Drive SDK, and I don't believe it's possible to interact with that from AppScript today. We have been getting requests for it, so I'll follow up with the team and find out what's required basically on our side to make that possible from within AppScript, and I'll update on the issue tracker. But yeah, hopefully that's at least helpful to know you're not doing it wrong. It's just not supported yet. So I was going to mention Eric and Ikai, who are often here for office hours, are in Austin, Texas today because we're having an AppScript hackathon there. So I'm hoping that next week we'll have some exciting apps and scripts to tell you about that were built at the hackathon once we hear how all of that went. Okay, so here's a question from one of our Hangout attendees. So, can the content service do OAuth authentication? So, I was speaking with somebody else about this last week. So, do you mean kind of like inbound OAuth, so that basically you can use this as a web service, basically? And for those of you who aren't familiar with content service, it allows you to serve up text formatted. So instead of using UiApp or HTML service to serve like web-based content, it can serve up like RSS, JSON, things like that. And so no, today it's not possible to support OAuth. So for example, if you wanted to have them have it accessing data of some, maybe Twitter's API or something like that, we don't support that OAuth flow for content service yet today, but we know there's a need for it. Our engineering team is aware, and they're looking into possibilities for the easiest way to support that. So I believe there is a feature request in the tracker for that. If there's not, go ahead and add one in, and I'll hook it up with our kind of internal tracking process so that we can keep you aware of the progress on that. Okay. And any other questions? Yeah, I am looking forward to when we have that available for content service, because there's a lot of really cool things that you can do once we have support for that. Okay. Let me go just check back on the moderator page one more time. See if anything new came in. Nope. Well, in that case, we may have a very short office hours today. I won't.
Well, I could throw a question in, Jan.
Okay, sure.
One of the things that I noticed is once I installed it in the Chrome Web Store is the icon that came is the apps icon. Is there a plugin that published to the Chrome Web Store can customize that icon?
Yes. So that is something that we're currently working on. The support for that is pretty limited today. There is a complex way that I can follow up with. It's complicated. There's a complicated way you can kind of get the manifest. So what we're trying to do with the Chrome Web Store is make it simple for you so that you don't have to build the manifest file and the zip package that you have to upload to the Chrome Web Store. However, we didn't at launch support a way to customize the icon that gets installed on the new tab page, and that's, I think, the issue that you had. Because, yes, it's obviously a better experience if you can, you know, have the proper branding for your app with your own icon there. So that is something we are definitely planning to add. But in the meantime, I can explain a workaround, a way for you to kind of get that manifest file and the assets that you need to then repackage the zip file and upload to your Chrome Web Store listing in the developer dashboard. So I'm trying to think where is the best place for me to put this information. Maybe what I'll do is I'll post something to the moderator page later with instructions on how to do that.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay. Or do you want me to, or do you, would you rather a Stack Overflow question?
Either way is fine. I'll just put it on the moderator page since okay. It's within the context of this office hours today. And it's messy. So okay. Until we have the proper support built in, I'll just explain it here, and it will hopefully give you what you need, but not be too complex.
Oh, okay. And I guess one of the other questions that I've noticed have ScriptDb and getting some really strange things happening with that. I saw in the issue. I just wondered, is that. Is it B question B Or is it just sort of thing? What I did, for example, wrote just a simple little script to count all the objects in there, and sometimes it would come back with 4 and come back with 55, where I knew there was 55 objects in the store. And then I thought refreshing my browser, you know, doing that sort of thing didn't seem to fix it. But I would log out, come back later, and it would switch at a time. So my impression was, because the objects sort of came back, that it was integrity, it was some sort of connection issue. Do you have any
updates on it? So yes, there is
any updates or
and the audio was kind of going in and out. I think I got the gist of what you were saying. I'm going to kind of repeat it back to make sure. So there is a ScriptDB issue happening right now. It doesn't seem to be happening in all cases, but what you're experiencing, where you know there's X number of items in the database, but when you do a query, you're getting Y back, and even that may not be consistent from, for example, if you access the web app from the dev URL versus the published version URL. The engineers are working hard to figure this one out right now. It seems to be, I don't want to speculate too much, but it's not that the data is not there. You're just getting inconsistent views of the data in certain cases. And we're working really hard
to
fix it. Yes, because it's obviously not how it's supposed to be working. So that is a serious bug that they're they're looking into right now, and we hope to have a solution for that soon. As soon as we do, I'll update the issue tracker and let you all know. But we can definitely reproduce it, and the engineers are on it. I was talking to them about it this morning, so they're trying to fix it as soon as possible. Okay. Any other questions? Comments? Things you want to talk about? Okay. Well, in that case, thank you all for attending, and I think we'll just go ahead and wrap up early, and we'll see you hopefully next week. All right. Thank you, everybody. Bye.